quiet evening, Zamil and Damia are at the school trying to finish one of their school projects. Zamil had his earphones in his ears and could barely hear anyone around him. Hey, can you pass me that roll over there? Hey, Zamil, can you hear me? Hello?
Huh? Oh, sorry. I was listening to music. Can I help you?
It's fine. I'll handle it. But what kind of music are you listening to?
Oh, it's Chinese music.
I don't know that you're interested in Chinese music too.
Well, yeah. Wait, what do you mean by too?
Believe it or not, I am kind of attracted to it. Like the notes and the way it sounds, it's common for sure.
Oh, that's good to know. Do you know anything about its history?
History?
Yeah, like how does it begin and such?
Oh, you mean that history? I thought the history of me took liking on this genre. I do know some.
Well, can you share it to me?
Yeah, of course. You need to hear it even if you don't want to. Based on the legends, the founder of music in Chinese mythology was Ling Lun, who had requested by Yellow Emperor to create the system of music by using the bamboo pipes tuned to the song of the birds.
Is that so? Research had it that the Chinese music can be traced back 7,000 or 8,000 years ago by the discovery of the bone flute made in Neolithic ages. Is it correct?
Yeah, you got that right. Now that you mention it, it also had other musical instruments. Do you know anything about it?
I think it's pipa, shenxian, banhu, and many more.
There has a lot of musical instruments since the ancient days.
I see. I kinda have a question.
Oh, as always, I'll try to answer it as best as I can.
Okay then. Do you know Sheila Amza?
Of course I do. Why?
Do you know that she continued her singing career by breaking out to Shanghai, China, and eventually won the Asian wave?
Wait, she did? Wow, I never knew about that.
As a result, Sheila received the Kembara Award, an International Music Breakthrough Award from Malaysian Music Awards, making Sheila the youngest Kembara Award honored.
Wow, that's so cool. What happened next?
She continued her singing career in the Mandopop industry by breaking out to Hong Kong in 2015, by releasing some new singles, doing an international press conference, and establishing her second record label and global management company, Shilala Hong Kong Limited.
Oh, I think that's how she gained her honorific titles such as the Sweetheart Princess of Music and National Treasure of Malaysia, right?
Correct. For your information, she is the first and only Malay artist to have success in Chinese-speaking countries and Chinese record charts with her Sina Weibo account, having more than 2.3 million followers.
You don't know much, aren't you?
It's nothing. By the way, do you think this music is popular in Malaysia?
Not so. I rarely heard from any of my friends that they are listening to this genre of music.
Right, I think so too.
Even if the time has changed, the traditional Chinese music like Guo Yu, for example, must be preserved to let the new generation know the traditional Chinese music.
I agree with your perspective, Damia. Thanks for sharing some useful information with me.
No problem at all. Thanks to you too, Zamil. But let's talking now. We have a lot things to do.
Yeah, I'm going to listen back to my music. Just say if you need help.
Okay.